Hello there, welcome to Cards and Clarity Tarot, and thank you so much for being here. This is going to be a general weekly reading for anyone who might be connecting with an Aries. So this can be an Aries sun, moon, rising, or Venus sign. You might even be an Aries yourself. If you're familiar with tarot and the way the energy works, be sure you understand that even if you are an Aries who is not connecting with another Aries, this reading can still resonate with you. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns regarding time frames, energies, things of that nature, all of that stuff should be addressed from the description box down below. So I'm going to go ahead and get into the reading here, Aries. You're not Aries. People who are connecting with an Aries, I'm sorry. I'll explain it as I go. So I'm going to go ahead and pull the spread out here. All right. Okay. Okay, so the Aries that you're connecting with, the card that's showing up to represent them is the Ten of Cups, all right? So I feel like they're a very happy individual, or this is something they want here, all right? They know what they want in terms of their own personal fulfillment, because Ten of Cups to me is a card of your own wish fulfillment, emotional fulfillment. It doesn't have to be, you know, a marriage, a house, a dog, and kids, but it's like, you know, it's whatever makes you happy, whatever personally would make you happy. That's what the Ten of Cups is. I feel like this Aries is aware of what they want. The way that they come across to others is the Ten of Wands. So they come across as a very burdened individual is what I feel like saying here. This is Sagittarian energy with this card. But I feel like they come across to other people as someone who carries a lot on their back is what I feel like saying here. Even though that's not the way that the figure is pictured in this card, that's how they feel to other people. That's how they come off to other people. It's the energy they carry with them. It's very stressful, okay? So they come off as a very stressed out individual, all right? They know what they want. They know what they want in terms of emotional fulfillment. I think they have a lot of passion, this Aries does, okay? With this Eight of Wands showing up as their you know, their dominant inward trait, because this is their dominant outward trait, okay? So this is how others view them, generally speaking. This is how their dominant inward trait, so this is something others might not know about them. They do have a lot of passion. They do know exactly what they want. I just don't think that they go after it because they don't feel that they deserve it. This Aries, they don't seem to know themselves a whole lot. They know what they want, but they don't have the confidence to approach it, which is weird for an Aries, but that's what I'm feeling here. You know, there's no figure present in this card. A lot of the time that can indicate, you know, an identity, sense of identity loss that this Aries might be feeling, okay? So they might be feeling unworthy of the things that they want here, all right? So they want to move in. This is Mercury in Sagittarius. They want movement. They want to move on their passions. They want to follow their inclinations, but there are other things that are holding them back, holding them down. I'm unsure of what that is, okay? But I feel like it's something personal, all right? It's something from their past. Six of Cups is showing up here. It's something from their past, okay? Two of Wands coming out. Excuse me, Two of Swords coming out as the way that they view love. So they're indecisive when it comes to love. I think they want love, but they're closed off to it, okay? Because, you know, love is an emotion. I feel like this Aries in particular is closed off emotionally. This is Moon in Libra. You know, Moon is a lot about emotions. They're just closed off. They're cold. They're distant when it comes to love, okay? I think they do want happiness because it's Ten of Cups. They're just closing themselves off to this Ten of Cups, just the way that it's lining out here, all right? So they're closing themselves off to their own happiness because they don't feel like they can maintain it, okay? That's what this is here. They don't feel like they could maintain it, okay? They feel like it would slip away, all right? Two of Wands is the way that they appear to be handling this connection. Again, there are two twos showing up here. So there's a decision that has to be made, all right? So this is how they appear to be handling this connection. They're indecisive. They're back and forth. They're 1 foot in, 1 foot out, all right? Their intentions here are the Four of Pentacles. And Two of Wands is Aries energy, by the way. This is Capricorn here with this Four of Pentacles. So they don't intend on letting go of this, okay? They don't intend on letting go of this at all whatsoever. Their goal here is, you know, you might be a Taurus. It's a Hierophant. They want commitment, all right? Possibly even marriage, but they want a higher level of commitment with you. Whether they're saying that or not, I don't think they are. But I do feel like this could be someone from your past, all right? This is how they're handling this internally. It could be someone from your childhood, someone you have children with, something of that nature, but I do think they're reminiscing on the connection, okay? They're looking back on the connection. For a lot of you, I feel like you're still in the connection with this person. They could just be having a lot of realizations about, you know, the connection as a whole. I was trying to think of something else to say other than the connection, but it just, you know, that's the way it's coming through, so that's what I want to say. All right. So that's how they're handling this internally, but they're also not taking their emotions very seriously. Six of Cups could be, to me, it's a card of, like, childlike energy, right? So I feel like they're not taking something very seriously. It's also a card reminiscing to me. So I feel like they're reminiscing on the connection. They're analyzing the connection, but it's also, like, at the same time, I feel like for another group, they're not really taking their emotions seriously in regards to this, if that makes sense, okay? What's coming up for what's at risk here is Eight of Pentacles, all right? So there's some work that's going to have to be done here. There's some things they're going to have to face, all right? There's some things they're going to have to take this blindfold off to and face in this connection, okay? Seven of Wands showing up as the obstacle present here. The obstacle present here is obstacles, all right? They're putting up blockages to their emotions, all right? They're blocking you out. They're closing you out. They're shutting down. So it's like, how do they expect to have this when they're in this kind of energy? You know what I'm saying? But it's like, I do feel like they're closing off to that, okay? Let me see here. Yeah, I feel like they want to make an offer here, okay? They want to shut down from this perspective here. Because to me, ten of Swords is like an ending, but it's also a new beginning. If you look at this yellow back here, okay, there's a new beginning on the horizon here. There's a Sun card right underneath this Ace of Wands, okay? I don't know if I even show that properly, but they want to be honest with you, okay? They want to be honest with you. They want to make you an offer of commitment. They want to communicate with this Ace of Swords. There's an Ace of Swords right here as well. But yeah, the Sun card, they want something new here, all right? Like I said, new beginnings on the horizon. So I think they're going to be putting an end to this perspective is what I feel like saying here. And I feel like it's going to end and you're going to, the connection is going to be nurtured. They're going to nurture the connection for a change is what I feel like saying here. Yeah, they're going to offer their cup, okay? They're going to offer their cup with this Knight of Cups showing up here. You could be a Taurus or a Libra, Pisces, Gemini. I've got pretty much everything out here, but I just like to announce the energies of the cards. Not that it's the sign, but it's the energy that comes with the cards, okay? Because that's they play a role in my meanings of the cards. So that's what I feel like saying here to those of you who are connecting with an Aries. If this reading didn't resonate, you could always try back next week. If it did, though, please give it a thumbs up, comment, share, subscribe, tap the bell icon if you'd like to receive notifications for when I upload new content. Thanks so much for watching. Have a great week.